magazines. Weren't those things that existed before the internet?
Oh my gosh, I still look at magazines. I still look at magazines. I love my magazines.
I know. I like pages. You know, I don't love Kindles. I like feeling pages and books.
Yeah, I like to
books,
feel the pages.
You know,
that's
something about
book lover. Yes. So that's something
comfort.
That I'm hoping will never ever go away.
Hopefully.
Never ever go away. Like those guide dogs that were so. I love that story. Yeah. That was
those
a
are probably
great
around
story.
For good.
I hope so. And certainly one of the features of today was how beautiful it was. It was really quite nice. Temperatures a little bit warmer than normal. We saw our readings back up into the low 80s. 84 was our daytime high. And notice that it is usually 80 degrees this time of the year, 61 for the overnight low. We haven't seen 40 around here for a while, and we're not going to, by the way. This weekend is still going to be nice and mild. We're looking at temperatures in the 50s and 60s to our north and down to the south, still very close to 80 degrees. But along the west coast of Florida, temperatures right now are getting very close to the 60s. So we're seeing this just about everywhere. And right here across our viewing area, mostly temperatures are in the 70s, right at that 70 degree mark. And they're going to drop just a few more degrees, and that's going to be about it. So presently it's 70 degrees at the airport. The dew point is at 68 degrees, and the humidity is at 93%. So there's a little bit of a feel of moisture in the air. Winds are coming in out of the east northeast, and they've died down since earlier this evening. We have cloudy skies in some locations, but not a whole lot of cloud cover. And it's very difficult to tell, even with this satellite imagery, about the cloud cover that we are seeing. But we have had some rain, mostly along the east coast of Florida, and the stronger winds earlier today really pushing those showers all the way over to the west coast. Not a whole lot of rainfall at all, nothing that accumulated, so we don't have any rainfall amounts that we're totaling for you, but you can see some of these showers are now beginning to get a little bit stronger, and we are expecting them to make their way over to the west coast for the early morning time period, the overnight time period, early morning, tomorrow morning. Not a whole lot going on right now, but notice our future radar is bringing these showers in 2, 3, 4 o'clock in the morning, and they're going to be hanging around for a little bit during the morning hours, and then they reappear after a lengthy period of sunshine later in the day. So we had the one cold front that already came through us on Friday. Now here's the secondary one. This one is going to be coming on through Monday for our area. It will cool us off only slightly, but tomorrow we're going to see mostly sunny skies for a large part of the day. We're going to see our temperature highs back up into the 80s as a result. We get the early morning rains, and the latter part of the day we'll also see some showers. So that'll be the breakout for tomorrow. And if you're heading out to the beach, it's going to be a great day. Northeasterly winds at 15 knots, seas 2 to 4 feet, with a moderate chop out on the bay and inland waters. So tonight, we get those isolated showers coming on through during the overnight time period. 10 to 20% chance of rains. Temperature lows in the 60s. Mostly sunny for tomorrow with partly cloudy skies, 82 degrees. We've got rain in the morning, possibility of rain in the afternoon and evening. And this is what it looks like over the next several days. A 20% chance of rain starting Sunday and into Monday, and then breezy conditions Wednesday through Friday with temperatures back up and down into the 70s. How about that, Adam?